the Screamies, everyone. So, we were supposed to, you know, do some Screamies last night. Unfortunately, the stream seemed to be shitting itself. We were at, what was it, 30% dropped frames, which, with a new computer, I would assume it's not the computer's, so unfortunately we couldn't stream last night. But here we are now. So today we'll be doing a game that is very interesting looking. It's probably going to be the most different of all the games that we'll be covering this month. But yeah, you'll have to wait and see. So it's going to be a bit of a jump in audio here. Just bear with me, because this fucking game, it's going to take a second or two to get used to how this fucking game sounds. So, yeah, let's get into some Screamies, shall we? Let's pop in here. Boop, boop. All right, there's that. Pop that there. Oh, yeah. Oh, good. Oh, good. Come on. You can get it. You can get it. There we go. There you go. It's good audio.
September 21st, 1987. It's been 1 year since I first went inside that house. I have to finish what I started. What I am about to do has not been approved by the Vatican.
All right, so as you can see, it's going for a certain vibe here. Alright, so what are the controls here? To move, use WASD, arrow keys, or left. Okay, I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. So this is actually going to be our first PC game we'll be streaming, so we'll see how this fucking goes with the new PC. Face demons and cast them out with the space key or a button. Resist the devil and he will free live. Flee from you. Is there a run button? Is there nothing? Oh, this is gonna be a little weird. Whoa. I gotta turn this down just a bit more. But I might have to boost myself. All right. Let's see. I don't think I have any save data, so. Yeah, so we're going for kind of an Atari feel, I guess. A DOS feel. It's a very fucking interesting looking game. Let's, I wonder if that would have killed me. Okay, there's nothing down here. Just, me and my buck teeth, it looks like. Alright. Is this, randomly generated? Is this a bad idea? If I somehow run back to my car here, this is, gonna be a little concerning. Okay! Ah, you know, all the Atari games. Playing with space and time. What the heck? Fucking what is this? Oh yeah, you know, just one of those good old Atari games that people are afraid of. Hey, is anybody afraid of Atari games? Those, oh boy. What the fuck?
Chaos Reigns!
Chaos Reigns! Should be spoopy. Is this not spoopy? Is this not big on the spooks already? Chaos Reigns! Oh. Oh, come back, dear friend.
Suffer.
Oh, fucking. How's the audio? Is it good? Should I turn up the game a bit more? You're invited! Come celebrate Nate and Jason's 6th birthday. Saturday, May 3rd, 12 p.m. to 4 p.m. Directions: turn right at 1338 Snake Meadow Hill Road and go straight past the well. That's a friendly looking clown. Alright, so I guess we just go straight from the well. I don't know if it's reversed. Hey!
It's locked.
Oh. Shit's locked. What if I, what if I sneak around back here? I just sneak back here. Chaos Reigns! Alright, well. Oh, wait, do I have to bless the door? Did the devil do this lock? No, alright. Okay. Kind of stuff you use to make those monsters flee. I am holding out my cross, so I assume the power of Christ compels them. I am a priest. I am here for the... I was gonna say, I'm here for the Vatican, but at the beginning there, he did say that the Vatican does not know what he is doing.
Rob, Michael, I'm willing, please.
I shall now bless this pond. I caught some people walking through the woods around the house last week. Not kids, just regular adults. They told me they got lost while hiking. I pointed them back towards the road. The whole thing just didn't feel right. I think I should go dig up Bob's rifle out of the storage. Are these... Even the music sounds spooky. I would hope so. This wouldn't exactly be a screamy if the game wasn't spooky. Are these demon things? Are they, the kids? Is this... Today I noticed Amy's favorite tree looks like it's dying. All the needles are falling off it and the bark is peeling. I guess I'm more upset about it than Amy is. She's totally absorbed in her volunteer work at the clinic. I guess it's good that she found something she's passionate about. I've gotten ugly looks from some of the women at the book club. Kathy and her religious friends won't even talk to me anymore. Who needs them? Who needs them? I say as I walk through this forest with my cross. Alright, so... The layout does not make sense. So I'm assuming I'm just walking in any sort of direction. Until things show up, there's no fucking... There's no actual map. It seems to be randomly generated.
Is
it a puddle? So wait, if I do... No, okay, there is kind of a layout here, I guess. I don't understand, because I keep going south. I keep going south and we keep coming back to my fucking car. I think the game is trying to tell me to leave. The Martin's house lies about 100 yards off of Snake Meadow Hill Road. There's almost no driveway. Trees jut out in the middle of the gravel path, but it's mostly covered in grass. It was difficult to find the house, especially since it was already dark when we arrived. Father Alred, I was gonna say Alfred. Father Alred seemed to know where he was going. He simply drove straight ahead until we arrived at the house. In the headlights, I saw an old shed off to the right of the path. Father Alred explained that he would rather perform the exorcism away from the house, but the Martins had insisted that Amy remain inside. He complained that having the family present makes it difficult to proceed with elements of the rite. They may seem harsh to the lay... to the lay person. Okay, well, here we go. Oh. The fuck? I fucking knew it! I assume this is, for the house? For the who's? Ouch! Mortis! Wow. That was some excellent fucking rotoscope. I hope the rest of the game is like that. Mortis! They didn't really give me a fucking chance against that one, did they? Do it again, I dare you! Where you at? Alright. What the fuck is this? Did somebody explode? Bob. The kids and I miss you more every day. The twins and Amy have started their next school year here at home. Amy keeps asking when she's going to be allowed to go to real school. I think she's getting cabin fever. The twins are having no problems occupying their time. Yesterday they came in with their hands covered in blood. I guess they found a dead deer and thought it would be a good idea to touch it. I think we might have coyote problems, because when I went out with them to look at the dead deer, it was a pretty gruesome sight. All this just a day after the twins' birthday party. Can't wait till you come home. Is this the deer? Just exploded everywhere? Mortis! Chaos reigns! Yeah. Just realizing these emotes get changed, did they? I don't know any of the emotes on Twitch, so... If I go down, it better not be my fucking car- ooh! I don't get it, are these things haunted? Public Letour? Letour? See, I looked at that and I assumed that said lecture. By Carl James Osborne. Connecticut's Historical Connections to Witchcraft, Satanism, and Beast System. Wednesday at 8 p.m. Probably the most worthless fucking note I've picked up so far. So if I just keep going to the left... Oh, he dropped something! It's from a streamer I got a gift sub. Oh. Father Garcia, you are hereby instructed to release Michael Davies from your care and return him to his home immediately. Mr. and Mrs. Davies have already been contacted by our office. A representative of the church is currently en route to their home to discuss compensation in return for their discretion. You will meet our representative there and accompany him back to Rome. Cardinal Gifford. Ha. Huh. So, I assume something happened? Some fucking shit went down? Alright, so, is that the same well? That's the same well that we ran into earlier, alright. So if we keep heading north, So if you die, you're going to collect everything. I don't think so. I think we still have everything. There doesn't seem to be an inventory, so I'm just assuming everything is flavor text. So we head north. There we are. Oh my god! There's a spook! Chaos reigns! Oh wait, no, I actually do have a fucking sound effect for this.
Wow. What a mansion.
Wow. Just get back into the fucking game here. Mr. and Mrs. Martin greeted us at the front porch. Mr. Martin led us downstairs to the basement, explaining that Amy was down there in restraints. I felt for him. There was guilt and shame in his voice. Amy was in the very back of the attic in a chair. I thought she was in the basement. In a chair, perfectly calm, staring at us. It is hard to describe the look on her face. It's not the kind of look a child gives you. And now the music stopped. This is the devil's coat! Ooh. Can you imagine if this actually came out on fucking Atari? On DOS way back in the day? Imagine what horror games would fucking look like these days. Wow. Our purple child. I think they had more concerning matters considering their child was entirely purple. They didn't notice anything different. I don't know. Okay, so we'll go upstairs last. I assume this is a different room. Yeah, okay. Holy fuck, look at this bed. I sleep in a race car bed. What do you do? There's, seems to be no music. Oh! Oh! What the fuck? Is that you, Satan? Oh, okay. Alright, well, I guess we just have fucking Satan behind us. Cool. I don't know if I came into the house with that, or... No. Nothing. I assume anything of interest would be in a color. Is Lisa... Oh, Lisa, she's transcending all of our games. She was not happy with how our PT went. Fucking, I bless this child's drawing. Nate, he's got a bright future ahead of him. Is that a fucking jack-o'-lantern? That heads down to the basement, I guess? Mortis! Ooh. Let's check. Okay, we're not fucking tanking at 30, minus 30 frames. Everything's going good. So I guess it was the fucking internet. A fucking exercise bike? Guess that's nothing. Oh, well, clearly we have to fucking bless this rubber duck. It was Satan's duck. I don't feel safe in my own home anymore. I hear voices outside around the house at night. I don't let the twins go out in the woods to play because I'm afraid of what's out there. The house itself feels stressed, distorted, slanted somehow. It's like I'm walking through a carnival funhouse. Amy's condition has only gotten worse. I can't stand to be around her, and I just don't know why. She just doesn't seem like herself anymore. I want to take her to the doctor, but I can't leave the boys here. I find that the phone stops working throughout the day, and now I can't seem to find my car keys. Thank God Bob comes home tomorrow. I assume everything went to shit before Bob... Am I Bob? I don't... Few details here. More at this. I guess I was the only one who thought to check in the attic. When I got up there, it was freezing cold. Am I getting these out of order? No, because the note that said the note that said Amy was in the basement was also the same note that said she was in the attic. When I got up there, it was freezing cold. I found Amy standing in the back, looking straight at me like when I first met her downstairs. We spoke briefly, although it was frustrating to talk to her, or it. I experienced a bit of deception from the demon. During our conversation, she uttered my mother's first name, and in other instances spoke perfect Latin. I called for help from the others, but nobody came. So I raised my crucifix and began the rite again. So this is kind of like The Exorcist, I guess. Just with a far more interesting aesthetic. Everything's fucking haunted around here. Bob must be stationed somewhere in the Middle East because he sent over this weird-looking doll for Amy's birthday. I'll ask Anish about it next time we have book club. Blah. Book club. She looks like she could be from over there. Amy didn't seem excited to see the doll. I think she would rather have a phone instead. Maybe seeing a baby doll makes her feel self-conscious about working at the clinic. Is this doll the catalyst? Did it bring the demon into this house? Oh my god. Do I really have to try to fucking... The no music is off-putting, to say the least. I guess there's nothing in here. Alright, so I guess we head to the basement. That's a good sign. It's always where the fun starts. Though the note said that she wasn't in the basement, she was in the attic. Where's Bob? Where's the wife? That's not a good sign. It's not a good sign. What is this? Chaos reigns! Dear Amy, thanks for writing. It really brightened my day hearing from you. In your letter, you asked what's the weirdest thing I've seen as a missionary. The area we are working in has a lot of folks who practice Quimbamba? Quimbamba! It's what you might call a pagan religion. It's kind of a mix of Catholic and African religions. One of the saints they worship is San Le Muerte, or Saint Death. Yesterday we talked to a boy about 15. When we asked him if he had ever prayed, he said no, but I've prayed to San Le Muerte. He told us about a time when he stayed over at his cousin's house, and according to him, they prayed to some figures of San Muerte, and the figures made things in the house move around. He got real quiet and scared looking after that. Told him he could pray to God and that God wouldn't make him feel scared like that. We invited him to the church, but he hasn't come yet. Need to wrap this letter up and get back to work. See you in 4 months. Layton. Alright. We're, what, one, two rooms from shit going down? Oh no. Hello. Is there a spook hiding in here? Hello. Ooh. I guess I'll just leave and nothing bad will happen. Cool. All right, let's just grab this note over here. Amy's parents could not endure witnessing the proceedings of the rite for long. Mrs. Martin was hysterical, and the thing that was inside Amy was feeding off of the fear. Father Alred asked me to take the Martins upstairs. I was physically worn out, but managed to get them back up the stairs into the kitchen. Amy was screaming, "Mother, mother!" the whole time. Finally, I got them to sit down with me at the kitchen. After a few minutes, we couldn't hear much of anything down in the basement, so I went down to check on things. I found Father Alred lying on his back, unconscious, with his arms spread out wide. Amy was not in the chair. Fucking stop, stop, stop! Oh no! The rotoscope is back! Chaos reigns! She is here. Where is she? Where is she? Where is she? Fucking okay. So I think from that, when the four of them appear around us, I think one of them was flickering. I don't know. I didn't have a too long of a chance there. Okay, so the real one seems to flicker, I think. I don't know. Is there anything else I need to look for here? Boo! She is here!
I get you.
I really like that rotoscope effect they do. It's really fucking cool. I guess we head to the basement? Yeah, I guess we head to the basement. Did I heard I see you? Probably. It's all garbled up. Cool. Guess we head back to the basement?
I heard a door open upstairs.
Oh good. Oh good, let me just fucking saunter back up there. As the ghost and her fucking shadow jutsu keep fucking jumping me. Ooh. Ooh. Karen, the church might contact you in a few days to tell you their version of what happened to me. I want you to hear it from me first. A year ago, I was involved in the exorcism of Amy Martin. What they said in the papers about what happened isn't true. She, my superior, father... She, my superior, father, with... When I confronted her, she managed to cut the power to the house and her own parents with their own... Ooh. I have to go back to the house. The nightmares I'm having are real. She's still there waiting for me. I can still help her. If I don't come back, know that I love you and I'm sorry, John. Am I John? Motor piece. Ah! A fucking Atari game can never do that. I mean, an Atari game couldn't do all this fucking cool rotoscope, so...
My god, what happened to you?
My god!
My face is breaky! I have to finish what I started. She's my priest!
Let's see if your face is pretty. Oh! Is that Satan? No! Satan, be gone! Be gone! Holy shit. Holy shit. F- fucking okay. Whoa! Fucking be gone, Satan! Am I doing this correctly? I don't seem to be getting any fucking feedback here. Yeah. Okay, so at least finding the real her seems to tell us which way she's gonna come from. Oh, hey Satan! Hey buddy! Oh. Mortis.
Mortis.
Fuck. God damn. Alright. Okay, good. We start right here. Ah. Okay, so she seems to travel along the pentagram. It's good to know. Ah!
Mortis.
Mortis. Cool. Animation. I fucking love the animation. Like, you look at rotoscope animation, and you know, there's something a little off about it when you look at it. Like, it's moving too smoothly. Okay. So that seems to happen when I get touched by that red circle forming around her. So let's just not get touched by that, I guess. No, I don't have a sound effect for this. All right, fine.
Mortis.
Mortis. I assume mortis means death. Or, game over. Because clearly video games existed when Latin was created. Alright, so as long as I don't, like, be greedy, it seems to be fine. I don't know what the range on God's crucifix is. Ah! I feel like I didn't fucking touch that.
Mortis.
It's a big mistake. Big whoopsie. Shadow run button. The hitbox feels a little weird. Like before when we were fucking ducking and dodging in the fight before this, I was way closer to her and I wasn't getting hit. But now it's like fucking even remotely around her, I'm exploding into a meat pile. Mortis. Chaos reigns. At least I like that. I feel like I was a wee bit away there. I feel like I might have some more sound effects to my collection after this. I guess I just will not be greedy. Like, I get a good amount there and then I just run away like a big coward. Or this is something about death in Latin. Okay, yeah. I figured. It means not poggers. Okay, so she's getting faster. Ah!
More of this.
She tricked me. She tricked me. Okay, so I seem to be able to just can do it from the middle here. So maybe I should just do that. I don't know why I think I need to get so fucking close. Okay, well. But she's diagonal for me, I guess. Oh, hey! Five. Oh, it's fucking alright! She's just throwing Shadow Men out now? Okay, we're back to three. Did I fix it? Let me see a pretty face. Let me see a pretty face. I did it. I have purified the woman. Job well done. Let's leave now. Let's just fucking leave. The deed is done. The task is finished. Kill her. Why is it backwards?
With one bullet.
With one bullet. Kill her. Let's finish what we fucking started. I have one shot. I guess that's nothing. Nice dick, bro. Oh, it's huge. Has one shot. Just call me the one shot. Oh, well, okay. Are you, you okay? So, here's my thought process here. I'm here to, I guess, defeat the demon. Is killing the girl that is being possessed, is that right? Is that how I win? Should I shoot her? No. No, don't shoot her. All right. It's fucking you win this time. All right, well, let's see if there's any other places we can go. To that white. So what the fuck was that white thing? That was attacking us. Cannot use the cross. Nope. I assume if I hit space, I will shoot my one bullet. Excuse me? Hello, Shadow Man? Hello? If I touch you, will I die? Oh man, should I have shot him? I'm trying to waste it and then switch to your cross. Who the fuck are you? Ha! Should I shoot him? Should I stick the bullet in him? Alright, well, he keeps respawning, so I'm assuming we can just walk around a bit. I don't like how the gun isn't tied to my model. Do it. Can I shoot the white thing? Is that not something I can do? I could shoot the deer. Because clearly the deer is behind it. Clearly. Some sort of deer god. Chaos reigns. Really? Can I shoot the squirrel? Like, I look at this and I assume there should be a pentagram there. Let's see what's down. Me and my giant fucking cigarette. Oh. Okay, can we just leave? Can I just leave? I win. I did it. I think.
I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him I will trust. I shall not be afraid of the terror in the night, nor the evil that walketh in darkness. Because I have made the Lord.
So
my
we
refuge.
Just left a wounded what, girl in the forest?
Therefore will he deliver me. I shall
with that weird shadow man?
And he will answer me. He will be with me in trouble. He will deliver me and honor me.
What, was this the actual end?
I can't explain what happened at that house. I can only have faith that I did the right thing.
Was that the correct thing to do? Ending 5 of 5, when faith endures. Okay, so 5 endings. We shoot Lisa, Amy. We shoot the Shadow Man. I don't know, but Kaylor, just listen to what the backwards message gave you. Huh. Amy, Shadow Man. White guy. Is there an option just to leave? Like, waste my bullet? Or, you know, maybe shoot the deer. And okay, so we'll figure this out. Police, animal expert investigates chupacabra remains found near Sterling. Sterling PD is enlisting the help of local animal experts from the University of Connecticut. After the remains of an unidentified animal were found near Sterling. The remains of an animal, which some residents are calling a chupacabra, were discovered in Snake Meadow Hill Road by a motorist yesterday. The animal had apparently been struck by a vehicle and parts of its carcass were scattered across the road. Police say they initially investigated the gruesome scene because the motorist who discovered the remains had told them they appeared to be of a person. After arriving at the scene, police concluded that the remains were some kind of animal. As a matter of public safety, we want to be sure about what exactly we're dealing with here, said a Sterling police spokesman. It's clearly not a deer or a coyote. If it's a mountain lion or exotic pet that escaped from its owners, or an animal with rabies, we need to know about it. Animal experts attached to the investigation would not speculate about what kind of animal had been found, although they commented that the animal was hairless, anemic, and apparently suffered from the rickets, a vitamin D deficiency that appears in animals and children who have not received enough sunlight. That's it? That's short? Oh. Okay, well then let's fucking try to get those other endings, I guess. Yeah, it's a short indie game. I know that there's a chapter 2, but I don't know if we'll do that. Alright, well let's fucking kill her, I guess. Despite my best judgment, if it's just gonna drop us off at the house there after each ending. Alright, Amy. I did it. I did get my cross back. The deed is done. Let us be off. Now for my long, silent walk back to my car. I feel like this is the bad end. When we came here to exorcise the girl, I assume using a bullet is not correct. Just making my way back downtown. Walking fast, faces past. Alright, so while we're here, let's check out that squirrel now that I have my cross back. Oh no. Is the squirrel behind it? Oh no. Oh no. Does that mean the deer is also gone? Did the animals conspire against us this whole time? Oh, okay, the deer's still here. What the fuck? Okay, I guess we'll just leave. I don't know what to tell you. What happens if the white thing comes after us? Okay. Oh, yeah, that's gonna be a little concerning, isn't it? Ending 1 of 5. Murderer! Yeah, okay. I figured. Police arrest man accused of murdering missing girl. A New York man is in custody after he confessed to the murder of a Sterling girl who had been missing. John Ward of Palmyra was pulled over on Snake Meadow Hill Road last night after a state trooper reported hearing a gunshot. Yeah. The officer thought it might be poachers. The officer said Ward was acting nervous and suspicious after being pulled over. When questioned, Ward reportedly said, "I've killed her." According to the police report, the officer called for backup after Ward became increasingly upset. Bad idea killing her, yeah. Became increasingly upset, saying repeatedly that there was a demon inside her. Ward was taken to Sterling Police Headquarters for further questioning. Ward then confessed to authorities that he shot and killed Amy Martin, a 17-year-old girl who had been missing for 9 days after escaping from a mental institution. After a brief search, police located Amy's body in the woods near the now-abandoned Martin home. In addition to receiving a gunshot wound to the stomach, Amy showed injuries suggesting she had been thrown out of a second-story window of the house. An officer who helped recover the body told reporters that Amy's face had been mutilated in a very brutal manner. Oh, you mean a big fucking hole was cut in her face? Ward was found dressed as a priest when he was pulled over. It is suspected that he impersonated a priest to gain his victim's trust after Catholic authorities in Rome confirm that Ward was not an ordained minister. The rest of the article is missing. So am I not a priest? I'm just pretending? Let's go shoot that shadow man, I guess. So we have ending 1 and 5. There's 3 more endings we can get here. One is we smoke this entire giant cigarette by the time we get back to the thing. Alright, Shadow Man. Tell me what you know. Show me what you've got. Is this not just going to be their neighbor? I did it! The man is dead. Also, I can fix this silence problem. Here, let's put on a jaunt tune. As we head back to our car, having clearly gotten the best ending. Yes. Good day in my books. Just making my way downtown. So can I redo this? Okay, that's nothing. I feel accomplished that I did the proper thing. And this absolutely is not just gonna be, oh yeah, that was the fucking neighbor that was mentioned way back. Let me guess, the police again?
I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him I will trust. I shall not be afraid.
Father and son. So we don't... Who the fuck was the Shadow Man? Ending 2 of 5. So these are all shown in red text. That makes me wonder if these are the bad. So we got ending 5 of 5 and that was in yellow. Was that the good ending? The white guy was in our back seat. Esteemed Cardinal Gifford, with all due respect, you cannot grasp the importance of the work I am doing for young Michael without being present here. Michael needs my help now more than ever. In the past few weeks, I have made great progress with Michael's affliction. Nevertheless, whatever darkness is inside of him fights back with increasing ferocity. You must not let up on the fight against the enemy at such a critical time. There's another reason why I dare not return Michael to his family, nor let them see him. The darkness inside of him afflicts his soul, but it also causes a terrible strain on his body. So that there may be no mistaking what I mean, I have enclosed a photograph of young Michael during one of our sessions. The photograph is missing. Is the white guy Michael?
A gun with one bullet.
One bullet. Is there anything else in this house while we're here? Why is it written backwards? Why is it written backwards? Oh, fucking no. Let's go shoot that squirrel. So the shadow was Michael in the end. I don't think that shadow guy was anything. I think he was just some random guy. I think the white guy that has been chasing us around was Michael. I don't know. This is probably a waste of a bullet, but Chaos will reign no more. What did this accomplish? The squirrel was already dead. All right. Cool. So why was it gone that one time we went there? Is this gonna... It's gonna be some stupid ending where, oh, they were behind it the whole time. All right. We're gonna get arrested. Did you shoot that fucking squirrel, sir? Hey, I may have ruined your ritual, now that I think about it. Hey guys, I'm just gonna get back up. Ending 3 of 5, the offering. Oops. Oops. Sorry guys, I wasn't thinking clearly. Hello Amy, I'm sorry to hear about your parents' decision. It's hard for people to trust what they do not understand. I know you are only 17, but you are clearly an adult and you are able to handle your own life. Do not let your mom and dad stop you from following your dreams. If there's anything I can do to help you, just let me know. We are having a get-together at the clinic Saturday night, and I would love for you to stop by. We still consider you a part of the team, even if your mom and dad do not. We hope to see you there. Gary. Soldier from Squid Game. Let's go shoot that deer, I guess. Pew pew. Me and my giant cigarette. How is game? I think this game is very interesting. It's going for a very unique art style. The fucking rotoscope stuff has been really fucking cool. We're just getting all the different endings now. Alright, let's shoot that fucking deer. Clearly he was behind it. Clearly he is the reason Amy was possessed. The Lord send you to heaven. Amen. Like, sure, every fucking game can be PT, but when they do something like this, where it's super fucking new as in, oh yeah, this game totally didn't come out fucking 3 or 4 years ago. Was that the good ending?
And my fortress, my God, in him I will trust. I shall not be afraid.
Is the deer gonna be in my fucking backseat? Oh! Cool. Alright. Help! Somebody help! Quick, get your cross. I don't like this situation. Cool. The hunter. Ending 4 of 5. So, wait. Was the best possible ending to kill Mike... fucking Michael, I assume? Canada moment. That was a Canada moment. Unidentified body discovered near wrecked car. The site of a deadly car accident was discovered along a road near Stirling this morning, along with the body of a person who has not been identified. At 6 a.m. this morning, a resident called to report an accident along Snake Meadow Hill Road. The driver of a silver sedan had swerved off the road and struck a tree. A spokesman for police commented that the body appeared to have been dragged several yards away from the car deeper into the woods, after having been ejected from the front windshield. It was noted that the body had been mangled beyond recognition. Investigators suspect this was probably the work of coyotes. Police also noted that parts of a cleaned white-tailed deer were found in the trunk of the car. I didn't do that. From a white-tailed deer, a hunter typically gets 75 pounds of meat. However, it appears the victim of the accident was only able to carry 25 pounds back to the car. Was this whole fucking ending just to set up the goddamn Oregon Trail joke? Are you fucking kidding me? Alright, well, let's fucking... check the basement. Why is the text backwards? What if I shoot a mannequin? I'm not gonna do that. Unless the mannequin fucking comes at me. Alright. Check the mirror. Why is the doll down here? Why is the doll down here? You know what? You know what? The mirror might be why the text is backwards. Remember when we went to the mirror earlier and there was a ghost behind us? A spookums? This... Okay, so first of all, he doesn't have a gun. Second of all, the reflection is like a frame behind us. All right. Well. Did I do it? What did that accomplish? Oh, the gun responds! Oh, so I can just fucking... with one bullet. I can just fucking blast wherever. Who the fuck cares? I'd be like, pow. And just go get a new one.
With one bullet.
I'm gonna kill that fucking imposter in the mirror.
Kill her.
This is a big build-up for, you know, nothing.
With one bullet.
Mortis! Chaos reigns! Okay! Satan? Is this really what was behind it? Really? Really? Is this the fucking thing behind it? The thing in the fucking mirror? I don't understand. I don't fucking understand. So is this the thing we saw in the mirror earlier? December 30th, 1986. Dear Dr. McGlashan, it's been 30 days since the beginning of my treatment here at Yale Psychiatric Institute. Dr. Spinell, who has been so patient with me, has helped me understand my afflictions and has helped me find a way to move forward and accept the truth. With Dr. Spinell's help, I have come to accept what really happened in September at the Martin family residence. I accept that what happened was not the result of any supernatural phenomenon, but rather the desperate actions of a young girl driven to violence by her dogmatic parents and old church rituals that are thought to drive out evil. Is that what we interrupted in the forest there? I'm happy to report that since accepting the truth, my nightmares have ceased, and I now enjoy peace of mind that I have not felt since the incident. Given my progress since the first coming here, I respectfully request my release from Yale Psychiatric Institute, contingent upon follow-up appointments with Dr. Spinell in the future. Sincerely, John Ward. So, I'm not a priest, though I clearly think I am from all the dialogue so far. Was Amy... No. Like, I was going to say Amy was absolutely fucking possessed. She had a fucking arm reaching out of her face. Okay. Do I leave? Do I just fucking leave? I'm gonna take this fucking gun with me. I'm gonna take this fucking gun with me just in case. With one bullet. In case I get fucking grabbed by my ghoulies. You know what? Hold on. Let's go see Amy. Because she's not possessed. Apparently. She's raised by violence. And her dogmatic parents and the weird town rituals. Hey, Amy, how you doing? How you doing, baby? I'm not a priest. Okay, well. I guess we'll just leave you there. You belong to the woods now. Cool. Like, they can't just be like, oh yeah, she was in the fucking asylum because she was crazy. Because she had a fucking arm reaching out of her. I didn't just imagine that. I was not fucking turned into ground beef by nothing. Mortis. I'm gonna go grab that gun just in case. Just in case that white guy pops out.
A gun with one bullet.
Yeah, that does make sense why that text was backwards, if that was, whatever demon in the mirror. So is this how we get the true ending? She just is left in the woods and I'm not a priest. And whatever ritual is happening continues to happen. This doesn't seem like a very good ending. Oh no. Alright, now we can leave. Is this the best possible ending, really?
I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him I will trust. I shall not be afraid of the terror in the night, nor the evil that walketh in darkness. Because I have made the Lord my refuge. Because I have set my love upon him, therefore will he deliver me. I shall call upon him and he will answer me. He will be with me in trouble. He will deliver me and honor me.
Is there any difference in the ending?
What happened at that house? I can only have faith that I did the right deed.
Five of five when faith endures. Really? Da-da-da-da. Chupacabra. Chupacabra. Blah blah blah. It's a matter of public safety. Blah blah blah. Blah blah blah. Was I not supposed to kill him? Hold on. Check. Blah, 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 blah. How many endings are in this? I mean, that monster got fucked by that car. Yeah, but that was the first ending we got. And it kind of makes me wonder, like, was that a good thing? We know that, I guess he was Michael? I don't know. Hold on here. Endings. Ba 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 ba. There are five endings. There are five endings. Faith, PC, secret ending, maybe? There is a Faith chapter 2, but I don't know if, again, we'll do that this year. There are five endings. So I guess we got all the endings. All right, well. I guess that's that. So that was Faith. It was not very spooky, I'll say that. That could just be because my big experience with horror games and horror movies. I don't know, was it scary to you guys? If anything, it was interesting. Again, the rotoscope, the whole story, the aesthetic and everything, that was fucking great. Not so much spooky. It was unique. Yeah, I can get that. Do I have anything else here? I do have another game here we could do. I don't know how long it is. Hold on. I do have another game here. It's not, it's not like Faith. So, give me like, I don't know, a few minutes to set this up, make sure it works. And I guess we'll be back in like 5 minutes for another one. I didn't expect Faith to be so short. I'll play Outlast. Outlast will come! Can I trade Griff for a new dog? What's wrong with him now? Ooh. Boop. Nothing, he's just a mutt. Yeah, he is. He's a mutt. Alright, so give me 5 minutes and we'll be back with a different game. I don't know how long that game will be, but however long that game is, we'll see. So see you guys in 5 minutes.